Okay, I'm Roy. I'm a physio that works at 360 Physio, and I'm working on this young buck here.
That's right.
Hey guys, so what have we been working on today?
So here we've got a fracture here, and of course the bone is healing quite well, everything's going well, but because it has been immobilized, you're going to get some scarring, just the tightness of tendons, the tightness of ligaments around here. So today what we spent quite a bit of time is just trying to get passive range a little bit better into both flexion and extension. So we've got it now down to almost about 70 degrees. It should be about 90, but he's getting there. So if you look at it, he's getting there. Within the next couple weeks, we should have that full. So there we go.
That's right. When I first showed up, I could bend it. What was it, like 30 we were talking?
Yeah.
And so now, like that's a serious, that's past, you know, 45, so on.
Doing well.
So we'll be good to go.
No more wipeouts.
Yeah, so I'm heading to the racetrack, and I'll see you next week when I get back. And I'll take it Lorenzo easy. No crashes, just cruise.
No wipeouts. That's the deal.
All right, thanks, Roy.
All right, guys.
Cheers.
And we are back. Day two of repairing Merlin post-crash July 13th. So just got to take a re-look and survey what I got to fix today. And I only got a couple hours, and then I got to go out on a date. But yeah, let's get at it. Let's go find some parts.
So I installed these shelves in my trailer over the winter in negative 15 Celsius. And just going through, so we need some grips. And I got a lot of grips considering I never used any of them ever. Because I was there's the stock one. See what I mean? The plastic inside of it. But we're not doing that today. So what grip do we want on the left? And it's going to be a normal bar one. So it could be A. It could be B. This is much thinner. This is much thicker. That's the wrong one. Or C. I think that's all the options. And I got a box of foot pegs for the Woodcraft rear sets. So this is how we are a racer on the road, guys, you know, just spares. These are the shorter pegs. I got that many pegs, so yeah, you can see the length difference in these ones. So we got to decide on that. And look what I found, right throttle switch and left. This might be exact the buttons. Maybe I had some all along and I forgot. So earlier today, I was at Roy's Pinnacle Physiotherapy. Okay, so there's the throttle. You can see the actual hand warmer missing the grip. And then there's the starter side. Oh, and what do we have here? Buttons. Well, this one's broken too. Sort of, not as bad. What do we got going on here? Oh, interesting. Okay, so the inner one is the slick up and down. That's traction control. And I don't remember. This was just up and down in the menu. So we'll stick with what we got. So I grabbed the longer peg. You can see the breakaway point, actually. And then we can look at the bike. It did exactly what it's supposed to. Broke off right there. And we're going to go with the domino grip on Merlin. Later on, maybe I'll switch this grip since I'm actually doing this now, the stalker. The problem with the stock grips, you can see it's wearing down a little bit, but that's the problem. They last forever because they're freaking rock hard. So too much vibration. By switching to a nice soft grip, a little more rubber, it's just going to soften the ride, soften the vibration. You don't have your hands going numb as much. So, and this should just slide right on. And we'll use some grip glue. And that should all be maybe safety wire as well if we have time. At the same time, the handlebar needs to be straightened, so it's a 5. And we'll use another tool as well. What am I looking for? Oh yeah, I'll show you guys some tools over at it. Tools are always fun to look at. So these are Imperial. Then you got some unique stuff here. These are really very useful for getting to your headers. Along with these, it's like a wrench that has a socket end. You know, then your hammers and chisels and extensions and screwdrivers and, oh yeah, wrenches. I think that's enough for now. So you can see I have marks right here. I always use a mark and I line it up with that, where the thread would be. So you can see it's been, the bar has been pulled back and it moved. Now you want it to move in a crash, but you don't want it to move when you're riding. So it's a fine line to get that to work. If we take a look at the other side, yeah, there you go. Nice and line, if you can see in the dark. Yeah. Another thing to note is I always have a certain measured drop, the clip-ons. I try to get the clip-ons down, so you can see this gap here. So I was just matching to the other side, and I just grabbed my bolt from the pinch bolts, and it fit in perfectly on that side to see the distance. I can get my caliper tool out and be like, you know, 7 millimeters. And this one is the same. It fits in there nicely. It fits in there nicely. So I'm just using that as a reference. But I try to get my clip-ons low because I'm a tucked. I like to tuck, get real down on my chest on the tank. This is where it's nice to have a tool like this that you actually sometimes, you know, with the ball end, it's nice, but you got to be careful with the ball end because you don't want to do a high torque, but it's a good starter tool. And then I have a custom short little Allen that Q-Man actually cut off for me. It's just, you know, just shop it shorter to fit in the tight clearance. And then the other thing I want to note is I like to have my bars a little wider, certainly wider than OEM. I like more leverage. The wider they are, the more leverage you have. The lower they are, the more you can be in a tuck position and be comfortable. So I already loosened them up, but so with these Woodcraft, to change the peg, you need to access the bolt on the back. Now, which is nice is I didn't bend this at all, so otherwise I'd have to, or the inner. So what they do is the frame is protrudes, right? And then this goes behind it and the bolt goes through into the threads and then as a plate, and then this goes into that plate because of the BMW, kind of a weird design. There's that Loctite. Look at the Loctite. See? Loctite, guys, Loctite. There we go. One-handed. So, like I said, with the Woodcraft rear sets, there it is. It's gonna be a 6, I believe, as well. Now, what's important to note on the Woodcraft ones is there's 2 holes on the BMW version, and then you have a bunch of different marks. So, you can see the bolt is actually, see if we have this like relatively level like that, the bolt is at what, 7, 8 o'clock? 6, you know. So, then if you pull it and loosen it, you can rotate it, and the height of the peg is gonna go forward, back, up, down, or use the other hole altogether. So, you gotta note where it is. Other side as reference, so I'll show you again. Let's remember, and then look, there's like the peg right there, there's the little peg bolt. So that peg bolt was actually at around 3 o'clock, and then the bolt hole went right in, and then, you know, you line up the hole like that. But that's what it was, 3 o'clock on the lower hole. That's what I'm going for. Make sure it's level, so it's on this wood anyways, it all seems to be level. It's not, if I look over here, you can see, you know, you can use the guide of where the holes are around it, what kind of shapes, and so that's this design.
It is sunny today, and with everything, Loctite, blue Loctite, everything. We don't want the peg loosening up.
And now for the mount. The Woodcraft rear set plate mount. Loctite that. And then they'll be good to go.
So I hand put them in by hand. I'm just using this to wheel them in quickly. A little bit. Oh. And we're gonna grab a Seattle tool and torque them. So come back at you.
And there we have it, 2 pegs. The only difference is this one has a plastic cap, and I probably got a bunch of them around, but just for when you're pushing in the trailer. So everything looks straight. I don't have to OCD any issues because it is parallel to the bike, so that is great. So I'm gonna clean the handlebar now, use some alcohol, clean that up, and maybe tap a screw into that, and go see if I can find a lever. Get the bodywork put on, make sure this stuff is lined up correctly. I don't need to re-bend it. Put the tail on, make sure this doesn't have to be bent up higher or whatever. Pull the rear wheel off, put the dash on, check the kilometers, see when I last did an oil change. Put the front fender on, test it all out. Get to the track. I don't have much time, so. Anyways, guys,
My name is Marcel Irnie, S1000RR Merlin. Get her done. Like, subscribe, and share. Check out the Patreon channel for all the episodes. 100 plus videos on there that nobody else gets to see. Patreon.com/Irnieracing.
All right, clean off the bar using alcohol. Get it nice and prepped up for the grip. Clean it up a little bit while I'm at it. Grip glue. Except it's glued itself. I can't get the tip off without wrecking the actual. Okay, I got it. So we apply it onto the bar. And then we twist the grip onto it. So don't need too much. That's probably more than I need, but it is what it is. Make sure the letters are the correct direction. I don't think you can screw that one up. Anyways, I might need two hands for this and one broken thumb. I'll come back. Well, I successfully glued my fingers. That glue dried really fast. You guys just missed the struggle of a century with a broken thumb. There's a reason the bike is now sideways in the bin, because it jammed up against the wall as I was trying to push it. But I got it on. I didn't think I would. I thought it was going to wreck the grip or have to clean it all off again. Just the grip glue just dried too quickly. But not too bad, and I got it just perfectly flush at the end. And I got another set of these things. They're actually Radguard Australia versions. So I got a lot of these things too, but we'll stick with black. That's what they look like. So obviously there's gonna be a right and a left only based on the tip angle, but you could always change the end piece out, but these things are all the same. Always important, guys, is with anything you buy, don't trust their Loctite. Sometimes they don't Loctite it, sometimes they do, like rear sets, etc. So I'm just taking it apart and, oh look, Q-Man is backing up the big rig. This thing's huge. The big old Duramax. Look at this badass truck, guys. Take a look. This is a commercial break. In the commercial break, I installed the Evo One brake clutch guard. Essentially, I'm not about protecting the clutch. You can see the clutch still got ground down. What I'm trying to do with the clutch side is give the bike a larger surface area to prevent breaking the bar. So the bar survived the crash. It didn't snap, displacing the load. It's a larger surface area. When you hit the ground, it's not just hitting a bar, which you can pull it. It's displacing the load, and that gives it a chance to reduce damage. So that's my reasoning on that. Obviously, on the brake guard, the idea is to not have somebody smack into you or to get together and have it pull your brake. On this side, it's just about protecting the bike, giving it a larger end to slide on the ground and not catch the bar. Okay. So, here we go. This is really tough on my broken thumb. There we go. Gauges are in place. Bam, 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 bam. This is your up and down on your menus. This is the traction control. These are the main ones, okay? More traction control, less traction control. Bam. All right. Making progress.